الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله تعالى فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we thank Him, we seek Allah's forgiveness, we seek Allah's assistance, we ask Allah's help, and we ask Allah to increase us in knowledge that will bring us closer to Him. We ask Allah to give us knowledge that will open our heart and mind and make us live a life that's pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make every day increase for our good deeds and bring us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not very long now to go in the month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all rich in the month of Ramadan. The Ramadan, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to one of the Sahaba, his name is Abu Umama, عَلَيْكَ بِالصَّوْمِ فَإِنَّهُ لَا عِدْلَ لَهُ. There is nothing equal to fasting. The Prophet ﷺ said, there is nothing equal to leaving your food, your drink, your wife, to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, willingly, between you and Allah, sincerely. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appreciate that so much. The Prophet ﷺ said, As-sawmu junnah. Junnah, it's a protection. He says, similar to the shield in the battlefield. It protects you from shaitan, or protects you from evil. It will protect you in the day of judgment from the fire. The Prophet ﷺ said, Al-hasana bi'ashr amsaliha ila 700 da'f. Every good deed you do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will multiply by 10 up to 700. Allah says, illa sawm. No. Fasting doesn't have a number. Fasting is more than 700 times. Everything you do while fasting is more than 700 times. Wallahu yudha'ifu liman yasha. Allah multiplies to whomsoever. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, innama yuwaffa as-sabiruna ajrahum bighayri hisab. Those who have patience, those who persevere, those who are steadfast, those who don't take shortcuts. Allah says, don't eat. I'm not going to eat till Maghrib time. Don't drink. There's no shortcut. You can't do anything else about it. And the same after Ramadan. And the same before Ramadan. As a Muslim, we live our life with no shortcuts. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, live this life this way, we say, inna lillah. We belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are the property of Allah. Allah is our owner. He owns us. Every one of us, we forget. We forget. We need to, again, listen to a baby cry. Just again, go and find some babies and listen to them and remember yourself. You and I were one day helpless like that. You and I, we think we're strong, we are intelligent, we have money, we have bank account, we have cars, we have houses. One day, our mothers were putting us on a changing table. Every one of us. And who was looking after us then? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who protect us then? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who brought us up that way? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is a Rabb. He is the sustainer, the provider, the nourisher, the protector. He is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ramadan is the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ramadan is the month Allah chose to reveal the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called the Quran dhikr, reminder. Reminder of who Allah is. Reminder of all the messengers. Remind of all the believers, reminder of our purpose of existence. And we all know nowadays, reminder, it's ongoing. Every one of us have reminder in their schedule, reminder in the email, reminder in the mobile. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose the same word 1,400 years ago, that you need to engage with the Quran exactly the same way. You need to engage with exactly the same way. As you have a reminder on the screen and you rush to the meeting, you need to have a reminder of the Quran. And you rush to the salah. And you rush to the Quran. And you rush to the good deed. And you control yourself. So when the Prophet ﷺ called Ramadan, Shahru Sabr, the month of patience, is not only patience from the haram, keeping away from eating and drinking. No, no, no. It's patience on the good deed also. It's called sabru ala ta'a. You have patience to come every single night to the masjid to pray tarawih. You need patience to stand there for 2 hours. You have to have patience to keep giving sadaqah from your hard-earning money. You need patience. Last week we've given an example of the patience of Ayyub alayhi salam, the prophet who was so sick for 18 years, pain increasing every day, and he's not saying nothing. He's not complaining. He's not even making dua and asking Allah to take it away. Well, Allah called him, Ni'am al-Abd, this is an amazing servant. What kind of patience is this? But today, I'm going to talk to you about another patience. Much better than this one. Subhanallah. A better patience. Yes, there is a better patience than the patience of Ayyub. Because Ayyub had no choice. When you have a problem, when you have difficulty, as a Muslim, you have no choice except to accept what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have thrown at you. One of the Sahaba became blind in old age, Sa'ad ibn Abi Waqqas, blind in old age, and he used to make dua for other people. And other people will get well. And he's not making dua for himself. So one person asked him, his son asked him, Father, why you don't make dua for yourself? He says, Qada'ullah, look at this, Qada'ullah ahabbu ilayya min basari. Decrees of Allah. What Allah decides is more beloved to me. My heart is more at peace with Allah's decision than my own sight. I'm so happy for whatever Allah decides, even if He decides to take my eyes away. Brothers, wallahi, last week, a sister from us here, from this community, sister's niece, a 14 years old girl, you can say very pretty, very smart, very outgoing, very rich, very intelligent. You can't count the number of clothes, the number of shoes, the number of gadget apps and tablets and stuff she has. Normal human being like every girl will wish to be like this girl. Wallahi, that's exactly what happened. She goes to school, the college here in Newlands College on Monday. In the middle of the day, they call her father. Come, she got a problem. What problem? What problem? Mental problem. It just came just like that. It just came like this, suddenly. Psychologists and all these people say, they're still analyzing. Panic attack. Something happened to her. Somebody bullied her. Somebody says to her, you're going to die with cancer or something. Some just silly thing like that. And that human being, this daughter of one of our friends, not a human being anymore. She doesn't talk. And the psychologist and the clinical psychologist say she's very at risk of taking her own life. So when we talk, when we drive, when we eat, we drink, we go to school and come back, who is deciding this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not you, it's not your money, it's not the food you eat, it's nothing. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that decides. So the example of today is the Prophet Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. The Prophet Yusuf was a young man. Look at his patience. A young man, a slave, in the house of the most powerful man in Egypt, with the most beautiful woman in Egypt, the richest woman in Egypt at the time. And she wants him to commit haram thing. And she tried and tried and tried, and he is in a different country. Nobody knows him there, and she is the boss, and she is the most powerful, and she threatened him to put him in jail if he doesn't listen to what she said. And he's not married. It's the whole combination of a sin that if he does it, nobody will blame him. But what he says, patience. He holds himself and he says, Ma'ad Allah. Ya Allah, help me. Ya Allah, protect me. I'll put you in jail. He says, Rabb istijnu ahabbu ilayya mimma yad'unani ilayhi. Oh, I would love to be in jail than disobeying Allah. Jail in the old days is underground. Dungeon, they called it. In old days, jail is not like today's jail. And he says, I would love to be in that jail than touching this woman or watching this thing or say that thing. Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. That patience is much better than the patience when you're sick. And that's what Ramadan is all about. That we choose willingly to control our own desires, to control our own tongue, to control our eyes, to control our ears, to control even our thought. It's always to think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and reflect what Allah is giving us and reflect of what Allah protect us from. Last year statistic, 28 million displaced human beings. We just read the news like that. 28 million displaced. You know what that means? They lost everything. They lost their home, the computers, the clothes, their money, the family, the businesses. In this planet we live in, 56 million people die every year. We need to reflect at the blessing Allah is giving us. And when Ramadan comes, we become so grateful, so thankful that we will be doing ibadah day and night. Day and night, our study is ibadah. Our work is ibadah, but also we'll be involved in the masjid. We will be helping the poor. We'll be reading Quran. We will be donating some money. We will be coming to clean all this stuff. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is keeping an eye on us. And He says, whatever you do, even if it's atom's weight, it is written down. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it the best Ramadan for our community and our families and every one of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it the best month for our country and the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. So Ramadan is coming and we need to compare our action to the action of the Sahaba رضي الله عنه. If you're complacent, if you're tired, if you're lazy, if you feel you've done enough, you need to always compare your book, your record, with the record of Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman and Ali and Talha and all the tens of thousands of Sahaba, that they were human beings. They were in much more difficult situation than us. They were in a desert. You have to travel kilometers to get water. They used to only ride camels and donkeys and horses. It takes 2 weeks to go from A to Z. And they did the impossible. They did the most incredible. Nobody could imagine, nobody in the wildest dream, that this Sahaba will take on the Roman Empire. They will take on the Persian Empire. They traveled for 1,000 kilometers in the desert, in the heat of the desert, in the summer, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, قَالُوا لَا تَنْفِرُوا فِي الْحَرِّ. The hypocrite says, don't go, it's too hot. You're gonna die by the heat. Nobody think of facing the Roman Empire. But the Prophet ﷺ said, we're going to face them. We're not going to wait for them to come in here. They walk for 1,000 kilometers to protect the deen. In the heat, in the desert, leaving their families and children behind. Facing death, putting their life on the line for the sake of the deen. What can we do to compete? What can we do to compete? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most kind, and He says in the tongue of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whatever you do, you get 50 times the reward of the Sahaba. Because we haven't seen the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Whatever we do now, we're gonna get 50 times the reward of the Sahaba. This is the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. 50 times, if they get 1,000 hasana, we were gonna get 50 times. But we need to be steadfast, we need to have that patience. Patience to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us sabr ala ta'a. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us patience to do the good deed that Allah expects from us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to soften our heart and mind to do the good deed in Ramadan in every month and every day. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from all of us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the best opportunity in this Ramadan to please Him and to be competing with the Sahaba in the good deed. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our gathering, to bless our family, and to raise our rank in the dunya and akhira. Inna Allah malikatahu salluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu sallu عليه وسلم وتسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبيك وحبيبك محمد وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله وأقم الصلاة.